Now, we're going to be speaking with Mr. Seye Oladijo. Good evening. Thanks for joining us, sir.
Thank you very much. Good evening.
Nigeria.
Great to have you. So let's quickly get your thoughts on the elections for today. There's been reactions from it, even from the state governor, saying, it, you know, speaking about the low voter turnout. But what did you observe?
Well, first, let me just quickly appreciate the good people of Lagos for affirming their faith in our party. In spite of the unusual situation we find ourselves conducting these elections, the threat of the COVID-19, which is still very palpable all over the state, and the challenges faced by the umpires throughout the state, for me, largely the exercise has been successful. Well, some people have described it as having a low turnout of voters. I would say a reasonable turnout of voters. And you agree with me that in an election, the results will be determined strictly by those who turn out to cast their votes. We appreciate those who have been summoned the courage to exercise their civil responsibility. And there is a further affirmation on the progressive governance in our state since the advent of democracy in 1999.
All right, there is whispers of allegations concerning malpractice and rigging. Do you have any response to that? Did you also notice anything like that in the process today?
Let me just say, I shouldn't say I was taken aback by those allegations. It's the refrain of the opposition party, the PDP. And it's like going to a battle. Even ahead of the elections, they were given reasons why they were sure they would be defeated. So I would just say that we're not taken aback by the lamentation of the opposition party led by their chairman. It's convenient for the opposition party not to look inwards for their problems. And let me also say that if voters are not really turned out as expected, it's a reflection of the inept opposition we have in the state, lackluster, unambitious, not capable of offering any contest. So they rather look inward for their various issues rather than casting aspersion on the well-earned victory of the ruling party. You agree with me that it makes a whole lot of sense for complementary performance to have the same party at the federal and the state and local government levels. And it would have been an aberration for the results to have turned out otherwise. Looking at the performance of the APC at the various levels in elections held in the past, our party has the state governor. We dominate the House of Assembly. We have the members of the National Assembly. All this will count for something in the local government election. You agree with me?
Okay, and finally, I want you also to go back to the turnout with regards to the elections today. Do you think that Nigerians, you know, Lagosians inclusive, have a lot of interest in the local government chairmanship office and also the councillorship? There's, you know, over time, seems to be more interest in presidential elections and the governorship elections. Do you think that that may have also affected the turnout? A lot of people don't really seem to care who is local government chairman.
As a matter of fact, for me, the local government remains the most important level of governance in our country. It's the grassroots, the closest to the people. Our people should show more than a passing interest in who is their councillor, who is their local government chairman, because they are the first point of contact as regards governance, as regards social responsibility in the various local governments. And I believe as time goes on, the consciousness will become higher and we will have more people participating in these elections so that we have quality representation at that level.
Okay, well, let's see how it goes. And we look forward to speaking with you again sometime during the week. Thank you very much for your time this evening. Thanks for speaking with us.
Thank you for having me. Thank you.
Hello. Hope you enjoyed the news. Please do subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to hit the notification button so you get notified about fresh news updates.